Mani Sadashya, sir, as we are all aware, the electronics import made by India is a big press on a foreign exchange. After petroleum products, the maximum press on a foreign exchange is electronic exports. The Prime Minister has constantly made efforts to ensure that India transforms itself into a global manufacturing hub for electronics and system design and manufacturing. However, sir, in the statement that is laid, it is said that the modified special incentive package scheme is closed. Also, the receipt of applications under the electronic manufacturing clusters is also closed. And also, the disbursement of granting aid will only continue till 2022 October. Would the minister kindly be pleased to answer why these important flagship schemes have not been continued and given the thrust that it needs to? And also, coming from Bangalore, which contributes to 80% of the total electronics system design and manufacturing ecosystem in the country and the revenue, I request him, if there is any proposal to be made with respect to ensuring that Bangalore develops as a global hub for electronics manufacturing in the country.
अध्यक्ष महोदय, सम्माननीय सदस्य ने जो पूछा, क्योंकि इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मैन्युफैक्चरिंग में पूरे विश्व के साथ कॉम्पीट करने के लिए हमने कई सारी स्कीम दी और उसका बेनिफिट भी मिला, बहुत ज्यादा प्रगति इस क्षेत्र में हुई। अब ये स्कीम जो है, हर स्कीम का एक पीरियड रहता है और अभी हमारी जो नई इलेक्ट्रॉनिक पॉलिसी आ रही, उसके अंदर हम कुछ और स्कीम इंट्रोड्यूस करने वाले हैं। इसमें इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन स्कीम, क्रेडिट गारंटी फंड स्कीम, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मैन्युफैक्चरिंग क्लस्टर स्कीम, वो पहले भी थी, इसका नाम अभी EMC 2 है, तो इस ऐसी स्कीम हम लाने जा रहे हैं और निश्चित ही इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मैन्युफैक्चरिंग में इसमें लाभ मिलेगा।
So the ongoing trade war between US and China is a great opportunity for India to explore and exploit. However, many of the electronic design and manufacturing units are going out of China and are taking shelter in Vietnam, Thailand and such other countries. Is the government on war footing trying to make any efforts to attract and incentivize these companies so that they can come to India without much delay?
अध्यक्ष महोदय, हमारे यहाँ के जो यूनिट है वो बाहर न जाए, इसके लिए तो हम प्रयास कर ही रहे हैं और बाहर के जो है वो भी हमारे यहाँ आए, इसके लिए भी हम कुछ स्कीम बना रहे हैं।
श्री दयानिधि मारन जी,
allow me to ask a question. Sir, I should congratulate the Ministry of IT for making sure Apple has come to manufacture in India, especially in Chennai. But we should go back and see, this is happening because of the policies of the UPA. In between 2004 and 2009, when Nokia started manufacturing, the same factory is now being taken over to manufacture for Apple phones. And moreover, sir, it is also because of the legacy of the UPA government and then IT minister, because of all the Foxconn, Flextronics and all the IT setup was set there. I'm sure, sir, while taking credit, the Ministry of the IT should give the credit to the then UPA government for being such good policy then to make a base for all the maximum IT industry to come to India. In fact, Samsung is there, is still operating here. And sir, in fact, we appreciate for you to support the instant efforts taken by the then UPA government and continue rather blocking it. Thank you, sir.
अध्यक्ष महोदय, सम्माननीय सदस्य ने जो भावना व्यक्त की उसका मैं स्वागत करता हूँ और ये ऐसा क्षेत्र है कि इसमें हमको सबको मिलकर साथ में काम करना होगा, तो आप सभी लोगों का सहयोग मैं इसमें अपेक्षित करता हूँ, स्वागत करता हूँ। और जो कुछ हो रहा, एक तो आप मानेंगे कि हम भी